Hello and welcome. My name is Victor Frescura from Danfoss Climate Solution, and in this video we are going to take a closer look on how to start with M6 design.
For designing the user interface, we go inside the user interface tab. From the starting template, there is only one screen named main form. It must be named like this because the software will use it for starting the navigation inside the custom screen. So we do click over the screen, and now considering that the M606D screen is smaller than the standard one, we replace the screen with a small template, paying attention to name it as main form. We go back for checking that the screen got the right name. It is okay. And now inside again for developing the main screen. I adjust the position. We start with the on-off status. So from the component tab, we drag and drop the brick var text that will allow us to show a text. We set the maximum number of characters, that in this case is 3. We'll use also the string selector in order to switch between on and off in relation to the logic variable system on off. That is inside the tab resources status variable. We enter inside the SL windows the string to use when the variable is equal to 0 or 1. We add also the time and the date from the M6 RTC by using the brick RTC info. Here, as in the other tab, it's possible to check the online help pushing the F1 button. The output of the RTC info are a strings type, so for showing it, we must use the var text brick. We adjust the position. We add also a separation line by using the form horizontal line. The number of pixels of the M606D screen is 98. Here a pixel is 2 spaces, so if we like to cover all the length, we must enter in the wide item 196, that is the twice of the amount. We adjust the position with the arrow. Now we add an icon for showing the alarm. We must use the brick var image. It has 2 inputs. One is for defining the image to show, and the other one is for show the image. Inside the tab resources icon image list, there are all the available images. In this case, there is already one for the alarm, that is alarm 16. We drag and drop the variable and we connect it with the pin icon index. From the status variable menu, we select the hotspot that reports the alarm status and we connect it to the pin icon status. We use an icon also for showing the valve status. We adjust the position and we look for the pump 16 icon. It is not a valve, but we use it for make it short. We use the hotspot W valve for switching it on. We like also to show the level status. So from the component tab, we use the brick var text for show a text. Inside the var text windows item value, we enter the description string level. We adjust the position and just below we add another string related to the water level. For doing it we use the brick smux that is a multiple string selector. The hotspot level works fine in this case because it is equal to 0 when both the level are open, so we can take it as a minimum. Equal to 2 when we are in standard condition and finally able to fire when the tank is full of water. About the SMUX bricks, when the variable level goes over 3, the output gets the value of pin in 3, so it works fine for what we are going to show. For the in 3 input, we use a string, so we go in the MCX shape. Tab application string, and with the right click we add a new string. We save and we go back to the MCX design. The plus on doing it is the one that the string can be translated and the user interface can take the right string in relation to the languages that has been selected. Now back in the MCX design, resources tab, inside the menu string table we find the new string. We drag and drop it, connect, save and compile. Now we're ready for simulating the user interface. We go in the logic tab for being ready. I've checked the logic variable and we push the button start debug. The simulator start, we notice that it is the M6061V simulator. For our application we use the M6061D, so we go inside the simulator setting by pushing the button with the screwdriver icon. Here we look for the device M6061D. With the button OK, we go back, we switch off the simulator for switching it on again in order to reload in the interface. Holding the up button, we act on the parameter system on off. It is a shortcut that avoids to go inside the menu. In the same way, we switch on again the application and we see that after 5 seconds, the valve opens because the level is minimum. We close the low water level with the digital input 2 and the level becomes standard. We close also the high water level with the digital input 1 and the level becomes max. The pump runs for some additional seconds due to the minimum on time. Now we try the alarm playing with the water levels. It is pretty easy to generate the alarm because it's enough closing only the high water level. We got the alarm, we got the icon, the red LED and the buzzer ring. With the escape button we get directly the active alarm menu. It can be also get from the menu. We saw that the incongruous level alarm is activated. Considering that it is an automatic reset alarm, we resetting it just closing the low water level. Now I'm going to show how add another custom screen. Inside the user interface tab, from the components, I take a new screen, clicking on it, I can start to develop it. We use a small format template, we change the name in status, here is not required specific name. With the red arrow button I go back, and here we can link the two screens just connecting the arrows with the corners. The arrow represents the M6 button, the corner represents the screen to show. Now we go inside the new screen, we adjust the position and we add the status of level variable before we enter a string for the description. And after the level value. We add the OK min off status. In this case, after the description, we like to show a text. So we use SSL brick, and in base of the variable, we show the text yes or no. finally, we add the OK min on status. Okay, we type the description, and here we just show the value of the OK min on status. So we connect directly. We can save and compile. Compiling process goes well. And now we can simulate the software. With the down button, we go inside the screen status. With the up button, we go back. We move the digital input. Something happened. We go in the screen status with the down arrow. And moving the digital input, we saw that level, min off and min on time changing according to the logic. Ask to go back to the main status. This one is the base for develop the user interface. And now you should be ready to use the M6 design.
Thank you for watching. For more information, please contact your local Danfoss support or visit our website, danfoss.com. Bye bye.